Hey guys, it's Denise and welcome back. Today we are at Grey Garden and I did a video on this a little while back. I'll leave a link in the description, of course, to the greenhouse build that I did here, the bunkhouse and the workshop. I did have to tear some of the greenhouse down though to make room for the grocery store, which is right behind me, and I didn't want to spoil the surprise by starting off the video by showing you the actual grocery store. So it's pretty big, it's heavily decorated, and so we'll just go through this very slowly like we always do, and so you can see all the details and some of the stuff that I have used in the build. So yeah, let's just get this started here. Now, I do want to say before I start the tour that I have organized some of the videos, not all of them yet. I'm still in the process of organizing them into playlists so that y'all can find the videos easier on the channel, like what's modded, what's unmodded, if you're looking for a specific settlement video. So yeah, I did that, and so hopefully you'll be able to find the videos on the channel a little bit easier. So here we go. Here is the Grey Garden grocery store. And here's their baskets, big baskets. And I just carried these over from Super Duper Mart. And they have stayed here the entire time. They have not disappeared. And so I guess I could give you a run on the outside first for folks that like to see that. It's a pretty big building. The building itself, I kept fairly simple. It's you know, nothing too fancy, but it doesn't totally look like a big box. At least I hope it doesn't. There are two levels, so there's a level that goes down in the middle. Stuck the dog houses over here. They've been acting good. They haven't been messing up any decorations or anything. Now, I do apologize for not having a settler at each post. Every time I would send settlers here or get new settlers with the beacon, they would not stay assigned to where they were. So I've only got two merchants in here. The rest of the people in the settlement are actual robots, so yeah, that kind of disappointed me, but it's still a little working grocery store, so I'm very proud of it. So here at the front here, you see two checkout lanes, and they've got their conveyor belts, and so you put your food or merchandise on there, and it just goes on the conveyor belt to the checkout lady, and she checks it out for you. Now, the conveyor belt is going the wrong way, but had I put it this way, then that big thing right there would have been over here, and I thought that was kind of intrusive, so. But it's, you know, it's the thought that counts, so yeah. It's moving the wrong way, but that's alright. So here's just some, like, impulse buy items that you see, you know, when you go to a grocery store right before you get checked out. They always seem to have these items here that, you know, they want you to buy. Whoops. Now, this is done unmodded. I did use the cheat terminal to give myself some items that I just didn't have time to go out and farm for. Other than that, everything, you know, none of the building or anything is modded, and all the decorations were put down by my own hand. And so we've got fresh produce, got fresh moot fruit, fresh corn, fresh carrot, and tatoes, which these tatoes are very weird. They keep moving and moving and moving like they're alive or something, and so occasionally you'll see one hop out of the bucket. onto the floor. So that's always interesting to have live potatoes in the settlement. And so over here is a little barber. It's nothing fancy. It's just something very simple. I don't know if I showed you, just right on outside there's a little place to smoke. So kind of makes sense to put that there. It's a sweeper from the Institute. And I didn't have anything. I didn't have any of those. So that's an example of, you know, something that I had to use a cheat terminal to get. Okay, and so I guess we should start it on the shelves here. There's quite a bit of them. So you've got kind of your hardware items here. And all of this was placed by me. No do-it-yourself, no OC decorator, nothing like that. And I guess, you know, working a little bit at it, a couple hours each day, I don't know, I guess this took me like about a week, I guess, something like that. Because the build was done quite a while ago, the actual building. I just had to add in decorations and stuff. Hope I'm not going too fast. I know some of y'all want to see exactly what items I used here to decorate with. Gilded grasshopper is another thing I gave to myself. You get it from a quest, but I sold mine because I didn't know I could use it for decorating. So I just, kind of like the flower shop, I gave it back to myself, kind of like I did with the swan boat fragments. Kind of the housewares departments here. Some of these items are really hard to work with, the bowls especially. I don't think I've ever tried stacking the bowls before. And let me tell you, they are pretty annoying. And of course, if you've ever decorated with the cake pans before, you know they're annoying too. They kind of move on their own, kind of like the tomatoes do. They'll just start spinning and moving around. Also, these frying pans and little saucepans don't want to stack or place very well, but I managed to get them on here to where they look a little bit organized at least. Tea kettles, they won't stack because of their handles. So just have to do single row of them on a shelf. Coffee pots are great because they take up the shelf quite good and you can just put a single row. They don't take long to stock these at all. Okay, so here we are at the where the Vim is being sold. And I tried to stock everything that was like a container. Tried to put something in every container. Because they would definitely have, you know, extra stock. Being it's a grocery store, and on some of these I wasn't able to put like an extra row, so you'll see kind of like, you know, it's like looks like it's missing one row, but it's really not. We're just gonna pretend like people bought that up. So like the alcohol, I've never really tried to stock the alcohol in this particular way. And the alcohol was pretty annoying too, especially the square-shaped bottles. These were annoying to stock, and these too. The wine and the beer wasn't as bad, but And the Gwinnets weren't that bad either. But for some reason, these things, they just... It's like they have a mind of their own. I've got some Deezer's lemonade up there. And these are Slocum Joe's Buzz Bites. Dandy Boy apples, cram, pork and beans. I could have actually stacked that a level higher, but and I could have double stacked these up there too. I did have these single stacked, but I changed them into being double stacked. Those two. These wouldn't double stack. Potato crisps wouldn't double stack. Well, at least I couldn't get them to. There was barely just not enough room. Sugar bombs I could have double stacked, but they would have been hanging up above the cutoff point of the shelf. So I decided not to, but it's still a lot of, you know, time, effort, and work put into this. And I'd like to think this is my biggest junk decoration feat so far, but I'm not sure, you know? I didn't count or anything, but I know. I know, like, that there was over, like, 240 tomatoes and over 100 moot fruit, and there's, like, I think there's over 400 pieces of corn in there. Alright, so here's the part where I was talking about where it goes down to different levels. Just a little kind of a walk down deal here, and I guess I'll go to the meat department first. So we've got lots of stuff going on over here at the meat department. I brought these little blue baskets back from College Square, I believe. Yeah. And as you know, I use the weapon racks a lot for fillers. I don't always use them for weapons, so that's what they're being used for here. Place here where they cut the meat. Got some eggs, Meyer Lurk meat, lots of animal head on the walls. That up there I think is Deathclaw meat, yeah. And down here I put Boatfly, Mutant Hound, Bloodbug, Yao Guai, and I think Radstag is back there, or Brahmin. Let's go over here to the pharmacy. Actually, I think I'll do the cooler first and then the pharmacy. This is a custom made cooler that I made with my friend Dee's help. That is on a whim, 7737. I will leave a link to her channel in the description below. I'm sure y'all have heard me talk about her before. She helped me kind of with this, figuring out, you know, which pieces would look the best to construct it with and whatnot. But I gotta say, this thing was not easy to build. But I will do a tutorial on it now that I am comfortable with all the pieces that I used and everything. I know how to throw it up now pretty quick. Throw it up really quick and make it, and you guys can too. And so what I tried to do is I just tried to keep the same colors together, like anything that was kind of orangey, earth tone colored over on this side, kind of. Doors, and then on this side I kept kind of the brighter colors on this side. And let me tell you, these corners where they meet are not easy to decorate. I really had a time decorating those. Okay, so that's the cooler there. I think it came out really nice. Really proud of that. Okay, well, so let's take a look at the pharmacy. This is the outside of the pharmacy. And I'll just go ahead and show you everything I stocked up over here. This day tripper was really annoying to stack, so if you try stacking it, you're probably going to want to rip your hair out. Some stealth boys, buff out's pretty friendly, you can stock that pretty easily, and it stacks good too. These wouldn't stack a second time, otherwise I would have stacked those.
I can patch you up if you need it.
She's got some stuff thrown up here. No, ma'am, I don't need any help, but thank you. Okay, and in the little cooler, there's some stuff in there. Yeah. And so we'll come back to the cafe here in a second. So you would pick your order up here, and then you would order it over there. So there's two little windows here that I've got going. Got their computer for whatever they might need it for. And a little bit of communications things over here. I really didn't know what to put over here, so I put these here. And there's not a lot of pictures and stuff on the wall. I just try to keep it kind of plain back here. There are a few, their little break area where they can eat, and then the doctor will sleep back here too. And if anyone comes into the settlement that's really in bad shape, they do have this place back here that they can put them temporarily until they are well. I know pharmacies don't usually have a place like that, but I thought it would make sense in the wasteland, so yeah. Commonwealth wasteland, okay. Alright, let's head on into the cafe. Decorated all the little tables up. Didn't put any food out on them though, but they look nice. Oh, here's something I did that's new. I put perfectly preserved pie in all these little slots on the Eatotronic. And I knew you could do that, but I never really tried it before. Or if I did try it one time, whatever I put in there wouldn't go. So, but those went in there pretty well, so if you ever want to stock those up, I'd say stock it up with something fairly flat and not big. So here's the little place where you would check out. Got all our machines in here. Stuff is all stocked in them. Glitched in the little bar guy up there. I thought that looked cute. They've even got a jukebox in here. And so I'll take you on the back side here. I always put these the weapon racks on the back to cover up those shelves and stuff, because they're no good to use for stocking, really. Especially if you're going to hand stock stuff and not use any mods. Alright everyone, that is the grocery store at Grey Garden, and I hope that you all enjoyed this so much, and I hope you really like all the little decorations. I really love doing this. It does take a long time, but it is so worth it to hear all the wonderful things that y'all have to say about it. So thank you so much for watching and for supporting the channel, and for all your kind words and comments. So let us end this by taking this tomato that decided to hop out and put him right back in his spot. Stay up there, tomato. So I appreciate you guys so much, and thanks for watching. I'll just do a one more once over here, just in case we want to just take it all in. I love just standing back and looking at it. It really is pretty. And, you know, I'm not saying that just because I did it. If anyone did this, I would think it's just totally gorgeous. But I'm used to doing this, so I know a lot of you look at it and think, how did you do that? But I've been doing it for a long time, so, you know, y'all can do it too. So have no fear. Start small and then work your way to something big like this. So yeah, that's it, guys. So everyone take care, and thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.